doesn't help. I can't hear it. That might be a bit better. Start up the pot. Always. Okay. That was loud. That reminds me. I don't need that going off. Any day. My head's a little crazy. Twitch being dumb. Something in my eye. So you couldn't chat. Your Twitch is dumb sometimes. Red, what's up? Got our glasses. Yeah. I mean, I don't spend too much of my day in front of a computer screaming anymore. I'm just tired. I gotta find a good gif. One that represents ASMR. Stiller from Happy Gilmore. Okay. Oh, I want to check. Hopefully that doesn't autoplay. Okay. Pop. What's she doing? So, Hide or Die, the Kickstarter that I backed, is at 42,000 out of 50,000. 42,000 out of 54,000, so they still need $10,000. It's not even been a week. I think it started on the 18th, so it's been 5 days. Okay, yeah. I mean, maybe in the next It's a Kickstarter for a video game called Hide or Die. I think it looks fucking sweet. And it's supposed to come out next October, and we'll be getting beta keys. I'll get, if the Kickstarter is funded, which it has over a month to do, or under a little under a month to do, so it probably will be, I'll get beta keys. I'll get 4 beta keys to give away. Obviously, I'll give myself a beta key so I can stream it in August, and then 3 to give away to viewers so that we can play, and I'll also get 4 copies of the game. So I'll have a couple copies to give away in October during the spooky the spooky stream month of October. Should be fun. Okay. I still don't know what I want to do for the second half of the stream, but we'll figure it out, okay? We always do. You want it? Dude, you should back it, even if it's $1. If you have $1, you should give it to them, because they deserve it. They've put so much work into this game already. To binge while I'm on break. Yeah. So it doesn't come out until October, which kind of sucks, but, you know, that's alright. What is she doing? That's what we're here for. So this week, I'm not too sure how I feel about this book, because I'm missing one of the covers anyway. So I never beat the first Dark Souls, and because I haven't beaten it, we actually started playing it on stream a little over a year ago. We were playing it on stream. Xbox One, and we got about halfway through, I think. Just, you know, life happened, and I stopped streaming Dark Souls. At that point, I think I switched to Overwatch. Hey, Void, what's up? I think maybe I switched to, as I dropped my book, switched to Overwatch, or I stopped streaming at that point. I'm not sure. There's actually a comic book for Dark Souls that started this week. This is Dark Souls number 1. I believe this is a variant cover. Yeah, this is cover B. I have cover A somewhere in here. I'm not entirely sure. this has anything to do with the story of any of the Dark Souls games. It has to deal with some Silver Knights and a guy who lives in the sewers who's like seems like a bad guy. His name's List or List Day or something. It's L-I-S-T-E. There's like Dragon Slayers, and there's the art in it is super good and super detailed and awesome. I just feel like if I knew the story of Dark Souls, we had 10,000 views last night. It's great. Nova, will you get out of there? Get out of there. You don't need to be over there. Last night, she unplugged my fucking light. So I feel like I would get more out of this if I knew the story, but it's still really good. It's only gonna be 4 parts, but it's pretty good. So that was cover B. This is cover C, right? Yeah. This is cover C. I streamed State of Decay 2. Nova must be in all places. She's just always by the light. Which is kind of irritating because I don't mind her being over there. I don't want her getting tangled up in the cords and like pulling something down and hurting herself, you know? Do you have like a huge shelf with all your comics? Shelf? No. They're just piled up in boxes. They're in like white boxes that are like this big, like this tall. They fit about 100 comics. And I've got like 9 boxes now. They just pile up. Okay. Next is more. No, that was Titan. This is Aftershock. 900. What do you mean 900? All over the roof. Her Infernal Descent number 2. This is kind of like a retelling of Dante's Inferno from the perspective of this woman. I haven't read it yet because I still haven't gotten a hold of number 1. Oh, Exposed. But it seems good because, you know, I like Dante's Inferno. I like the book. I like the game. I like that kind of lore. So this... I'm hoping it's a good read, but I'm not going to read it until I find number 1. The huge quality of your streams is that you include an amazing pickle. Yeah. I mean, what pickle? What are you talking about? I have no idea what you mean. So this is Pumpkinhead. Pure honey? No, absolutely not. It's iced tea. It's actually not doing anything. It's making my mouth more dry. I need some water. This is Pumpkinhead number 4. This is the variant cover. Pumpkinhead is of the Pumpkinhead movie fame. I don't know exactly what's going on. I did get to read a lot of the books this week. There's also a lot that I didn't get to, but I'm also 2 books behind on this. It's a 5-part series, so at this point I'm just going to wait until the 5th one comes out and then read it all again, you know, all at once. But it has to do with, like kind of old-style Salem witch type of stuff, like very, very witchcrafty and very backwoods magic kind of deal. And this is the Grotesque cover A for Pumpkinhead number 4. For each of man's evils, a special demon exists. This cover that subscription is over, or when it will be done, I guess. This is the second printing cover of Domino number one. It's so cute. This is the second printing of Skyward number one. Number two also came out this week. If you remember, this book is one day some science experiment kind of goes wrong, we think, and gravity just kind of stops working. Things start to like float, and everyone like weighs less, so they can jump around. You get like a 20 years in the future look, and this chick, the main character, is like jumping around from building to building, just because she can, because everyone can like fly basically. I do what I'm talking. Oh my god, you're talking to a bot, yeah. It's a little strange. X-Men. Keep seeing those ads, but all it is some realistic characters talking about how miserable their lives is, and it's deteriorating their useless life. Oh my god. I mean, it's a little bit more fun than that. Go back and watch the VOD. I'll put the video on YouTube tonight, so you should check it out. It's fun. So, I'm definitely not a big fan of Wolverine, but I'm a big fan of Venom, so I had to pick it up. And I've actually never read this, so it's, you know, it costs a dollar. Easy read for a dollar. This is the third printing of The Amazing Spider-Man number 798. The first appearance, the first full appearance of the Red Goblin. This book is insane. It's a good read. And the Red Goblin's pretty, it's the Green Goblin plus Carnage. So your comics in the future. Yeah, actually, we're gearing up to move. Yeah, so let's dive down the rabbit hole of selling books. I'm gonna go over a couple and kind of just to give you an idea of the collection I have, which is pretty extensive since I work at a comic book store, and that's kind of the beauty of it too. So I can sell my stuff, get some money, so we have some money to buy stuff when we move. And then I work at a comic book store, so I can just get it all back eventually, you know, over time. Let's just check out The Amazing Spider-Man number 798, the first printing. So I'm gonna go on eBay. $7.98 is the first one that comes up. Okay, third printings are up. this book has gone way down. It's like about $8 double cover price. Yeah, when it first came out, it was like $25-$30. She's so mean. That's what she says in every video. I mean, you do know that her parents are her managers, right? That her parents are just making her say this stupid shit just so they can get the publicity. Okay, so this book isn't worth nearly as much as I thought. Let's check out $7.99. Mom sells houses. Yeah, it makes sense. Also $8. Okay, so these aren't going crazy. Some of the variants are though. That's great. Alright, what else do I have? I have a spawn. Thanks. Show you what kind of tea this is, but it is in fact iced tea. Next we have an ash can. These are interesting. We talked about Stellar last month. This is Outpost Zero. I did not get a chance to flip through this. Iced tea is unhealthy. Very shocked if you had that brand where you live. It is very much a East Coast, Pennsylvania, New Jersey type of company. New Jersey, Pennsylvania, yeah. Okay. So this ash can is a, it's significantly smaller than a regular comic book. You know, that buys a lot of comics from us. Thank you. Thank you for having our books. Here you go. Read it ahead of time so you can tell people about it so they can buy it from you. So I should flip through this, see what's up. Try and get people hyped about it so that they can buy it, you know. If you're watching specific Twitch streams, the first Apple would be IVX. Let me see something. I don't think this exists anywhere, but we'll see. work, so it'll go by, you know, in an hour or so. Okay. Batman Detective Comics number 981. Nights No More. This is actually the last Tinian the Fourth written Detective Comics. He will no longer be writing for Detective Comics. Which is kind of sad because his run was pretty fucking good. I'm not sure exactly who's going to take over. I haven't been keeping up with that. I should know, but, you know, busy. Only have so much time. Batwoman's front and center. That's not Batwoman. This isn't Batwoman. That's Batwoman. Other side of the comic, idiot. It's been pretty good. This I like just because, obviously, I love variants. This is super sweet. Batgirl, I believe it's 26. 23. Not even close. And this is again, the DC variants are these pseudo virgin covers. So it doesn't say Batgirl all the way at the top. It says it kind of way down here. So it's not in the way of, or, you know, blocking any of the art. It's pretty good. I think the art looks sweet. It's even got, like, a kind of airbrushed feel. If that makes sense. It's not stippled. It definitely looks airbrushed. I like it a lot. I've got No Justice. Issue. We see, I don't want to give out anything too spoilery, but we see what Brainiac's plan was when they revealed his son last week is now alive again. Or alive. I don't know if he was dead before. That's confusing. But, you know, all the teams, they evacuate the planet that they're on. I forget, it's like Kolu or something. Kalu, I forget how to pronounce it. But it's Brainiac's own planet. And these Titans have come. And they've decided to come claim what was their prize. Brainiac's... Are you a Deadpool fan? Yeah, I'd say I'm a fan. And I don't ever read any of his books. They're a little too much for me. I read Deadpool and Cable, and that was great, but I read it only because Cable was in it. So this, we see all the teams kind of like, they start working together, and they accept that they have to work with good guys and work with bad guys, and, but the book doesn't end on a good note. The book ends with a bunch of giant trees. Hey, RQ, thanks for the follow, man. With a bunch of trees sprouting on Earth and the kind of impending doom that, oh fuck, the Titans that were on Brainiac's own planet are now coming to us. How you doing, RQ? But this has been great. This ends next week as well. It's only four part, but it's every week. I'm excited because it looks like Earth is actually fucked because the Justice League is very far away from Earth. And only Green Arrow is left on Earth. It's like, why they leave him and no one else? I think, maybe, I guess... No, because... all of the Teen Titans are gone. All of the Justice League, including Martian Manhunter and Dr. Fate and all them. It's literally only Green Arrow. Chose Sinestro to go over Green Arrow. Well, it was really Brainiac who chose it. Alright. Terrifics number 4. Killer Squid. I've been very bad about reading this book. I haven't read it since issue number 2. series comes out, it's only gonna be like 5 or 6 parts. Once this solo series comes out, I'm just probably gonna switch to that, because I like Plastic Man more than kind of everyone else put together. Mr. Terrific's okay, but I don't know, I like Plastic Man, he's cool. This might be out of what I've seen so far, this is probably the best book of the week. This is Delta 13 number 1. It's from IDW. I don't typically read IDW books, but this is a new one. It's interesting. It looks interesting. Hey, Tybone, what's up? T-Bone. Close enough. So, this takes place, I think like 20 or 30 years in the future. And it follows a group of people. What do you think about Turkey? Do you mean like the animal or the food? I mean, you know, that's the same thing, but like, gotta go have a good night. Go see you, Void. Talk to you later, man. Thanks for stopping by. Ragman's over. Ragman actually just ended. It was 6 parts. It was pretty good. They brought him back for a little while, and it was really good. Thanks. What? Okay, so this book takes place about 20, 30 years in the future. It follows a squad of people in space on a spaceship. They're going through the asteroid belt, and it looks as though they're like exploring for something. They're dropping drones on random asteroids, and you know, one night on the radar comes up this giant asteroid that no one had mapped previously. No one had ever charted it. And they were surprised because they, you know, it was in their course, and they were just gonna hit it. So they're like freaking out and whatever. And then as they approach the asteroid, they see that there's holes through it, kind of like wormholes. So they go through. They're like, "Oh shit, we're gonna crash in the asteroid. Let's just go through the hole and hope there's nothing in there." So it turns out the asteroid is hollow. I turn away from the mic to breathe. It turns out the asteroid's hollow. And they're trying to see what's going on. It's super dark, you know, they can't see. So they scan via thermal scanners. And they find a big heat signature. And they're in the middle of fucking space, like, there shouldn't be any heat here, unless this is like a planet, which it obviously isn't. So they send a little drone down, and the drone finds like a man-made wall, or like an artificial wall inside the asteroid. And at this point, society, or humankind, hasn't discovered any extraterrestrials. And that's where the book ends, so I'm super excited for the next one. I want to see what they find. See if it's like a big cocoon or something. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool. Or a big city. I think that'd be really cool. Our next. It's Mira issue 4. Mira, Queen of Atlantis. Was that a Chocolate Rain reference? I played the 5th. To be perfectly honest, I have no idea what's going on with Mira. It's a 6-part miniseries. And I'm just gonna wait till it's all over and read it all at once. It comes out every month, so I've got 2 more months over the hurdle. Yes, it was. It was. I know. Oh my god. This is X-Files, Florida Man number 2. I think I said this last time, but any news article or news headline you hear that starts with Florida Man is always insane and so dumb. Florida Man gets eaten by a crocodile. Florida Man eats bath salts and eats a man, or eats a live crocodile. This is only a two-part, this one and number one, which we talked about last month. So I'm excited to read this. X-Files was one of my favorite shows growing up. People from Florida are crazy. So I'm allowed to say that. Did I experience the insanity? Alright, let's finish talking about comic books. Remind me to tell you about my crazy Florida story after the comic books. Stay till the end to hear the story. X-Files is great though. There's another book coming out next month for X-Files. It's called, Hoot Goes There. Okay. It's a good one. This is Black Panther number 1. Number 1. Subsequently, it is also Legacy number 173. But also number 1. Because why not? It if it's a number 1. It's actually pretty good. But I didn't buy this one. I didn't buy Black Panther for that. I bought Black Panther for this. This is sick. This is a Stanley Archer variant. Hey Chef, what's up? How you been, boy? So, any variant that he does that I can afford, that the store can get, because sometimes they do his variants at like, you can only get this if you order 25 of the book, and sometimes that's, yeah, you can't afford that. Just a little more. Chat, please don't. Interest in The Witcher are goddamn annoying. Every time I load and save, it goes through our mini recap. And you can't skip it. So anyway, his artwork is fucking phenomenal. And I try to get every cover I can. Chef, this is your warning. Stop being a creep. This is actually for people who enjoy this type of thing. Myself included. Which is why I do it. Okay. Last stack. It's actually a kind of small stack this week. Good to have you here, man. Missed you. So cats, what do you mean cats? What? Stays 8, number 5. The noise. Do cats enjoy this noise? Ice cream really hates this noise. So I'm inclined to think otherwise. Days of 8. Remember, we've actually talked about two of these in the past, I think. This book loves to tackle sore subjects in the kind of PC society. Issue number one, a chick was leading like a double life. I don't know. I've never read beyond issue one. They're taking, I think, a small break after number six, so that's when I'm going to catch up. Issue number one, the chick was both a lesbian and are pretending to be involved with, she might not have been a lesbian. I think she was. But she was also a cop. That was like her day job. And as part of being a cop, she was going undercover as like a Confederate Deep South racist. She wasn't part of the KKK, but she went to this kind of rally in this building, and it was just creepy, and it was a really good issue, and I can't wait to read the rest, but it's 12 issues, so it takes a year to come out. Lots of gag toys make that noise, and Ice Cream is a little bitch. She doesn't like that noise where we make it, but she enjoys sleeping inside bags. Silly cat. But yeah, I can't wait to read these eight. It's, I love that stuff that's not afraid to kind of push boundaries to show you something or to teach you something. Because I think that's kind of cool. Alright, this is the third Hunt for Wolverine book. There was Hunt for Wolverine Lost. Maybe. Official Martin. Hey, thanks for the follow, man. Hope you're having a great night. I made some more things for you to critique. Okay. We'll critique them on stream. So there's four different series for Hunt the Wolverine. Hunt for Wolverine. Wolverine's alive. He's coming back. We just don't know how yet. And each of the miniseries is a different team of people and their experience with Wolverine, and they, like, you know, how they're going to go about finding Wolverine, or, you know, piecing together clues and whatnot. This issue, Mystery and Madripoor, number one. I don't know if they're all going to focus around Psylocke, but this issue focuses heavily on Psylocke and Wolverine's history. We kind of just get like a feel like Psylocke's like, oh, I wish, you know, the old Logan was still around, because they like had a thing. It's pretty medium, not gonna lie. I hope that 2, 3, and 4, which are each, you know, 2 is next month, 3 is next, the month after that, you know, it's gonna take a little bit longer, but I hope the rest of the series is good. But this is the variant cover for Mystery and Madripoor. Number one. It's Psylocke stabbing Wolverine. Pretty good cover. Another good one that I am way too far behind on. Regression number 10. Are fantastic for this book. It's a psychological horror thriller, spooker, you know, one of those words. It's very psychological. Did you read it? Do you want to give us like a 2-sentence synopsis? It's dope. Awesome. Official Martin, I'm gonna give you a awesome word of advice. And it's is also your first warning and your only warning. I appreciate your follow, but I am not a follow for follow machine, and it is not really appropriate to go into someone else's stream and ask them to follow you back or ask their viewers to follow you. I don't mean anything bad by it. It's just, that's just the way it is. It's a little rude. I don't know you. You haven't even said hi. You haven't tried to learn who I am. You haven't introduced me to yourself to tell me who you are. Lots of hypnosis. Okay. I guess that's a good synopsis. But yeah, Martin, that's just not a cool thing to do. I didn't make it to, what are we at now? Over 700. I know we're over 700. Considering what's happened in your previous lives. Oh, okay. We're at 728, so we're almost at 750. I didn't make all that going to other people's streams and asking them to follow me. If I made a streamer friend, it's because I went to their stream, enjoyed their content, talked to them, and just casually mentioned that I stream if they ask, or if I host them and they ask, you know. Just be a little more tactful, or, you know, don't keep doing whatever you're doing. But you can choose to follow my advice or not. Now that affects your current, considering what happened in your previous lives, and how that affects your current life. Okay. So it's a book about, not about, but a book that touches on reincarnation, maybe. Okay, next book. Or the maybe just the idea of reincarnation. Not sure. Infinity Countdown, Darkhawk. Number one. So, Darkhawk hasn't been around for a little while. I didn't actually get a chance to read this book, and I really want to because Darkhawk is kind of like a classic character. Been around for a while. But this has to do with the Infinity Countdown. So it's got something to do with the stones and Thanos and whatnot. So, I'm looking forward to that. And seeing how Darkhawk plays into this. This cover's fantastic. It's a gross looking cover. It's Old Man Hawkeye number 5. I think I've said it before, but I'll say it again. As I do with most things. I'm gonna wait until all of Old Man Hawkeye's out before I read any of it. I've heard really good things about it. I trust the people who have told me to read it and buy it ahead of time. I trust that, you know, they're not going to lead me astray. I'm putting, you know, 12 books on the line here. But it's got like this fucking symbiote guy, and he's got like mouths on his shoulders. Looks fucking dope. And I love the symbiote, so no matter who has the symbiote, I love it. Actually, this on Wednesday night is so good. I agree. Yo, what did you say earlier? Oh my god. Your chat color. Next, chat change to a different color. And sometimes it just happens with my chat. My chat's fucking dumb. Like, the physical box is dumb, not you guys. And that throws me off completely. It could be the same name, but if it's a different color, I have no fucking idea who you are. So I was like, oh, this random person that followed me at some point, maybe it was your last ASMR stream. Yeah, what's up, man? It, like, just clicked. I'm so sorry. What's up? How you doing? And honestly, okay, to the Wednesday thing. You know, I've got two more books left, so we'll talk about those. But the reason why we do this, not only because I love comic books, and, you know, I've got a comic book podcast where we talk about comic books, we talk about current events and stuff like that. I love talking about this kind of stuff. I love talking, you know. I love being on camera. But I also understand the regular work week and understand that, you know, Mondays and Tuesdays kind of suck. But Thursdays and Fridays kind of suck too, because you're so anxious for the weekend. You're so anxious to get done work. It just kind of drags by. You know, same thing in the beginning of the week. You get a lot of work piled up on Monday, Tuesday. And by Wednesday, you're just like, fuck, what am I going to do? So you come here, you talk about comic books, which coincidentally come out today. The weekend is meaningless. Yeah, I mean, to us, I guess. You come here on a Wednesday, which is when new books come out, so it's the first day I can talk about them. I could talk about them on Tuesdays, because that's when I get them, but not really supposed to do that. So I wait till Wednesdays, when everyone can get them. We talk about them. We do ASMR stuff, because it's soothing to some people. It's relaxing. A lot of people, you know, they just want to wind down on a Wednesday. If I did this on a Monday, it wouldn't have the same effect, you know? So I think Wednesday's a very good day for this. Okay, here's Skyward number 2. Again, this is the book we talked about a little earlier. This is the book where low gravity is kind of the norm now. These, like, she was a kid when gravity was correct, and she doesn't remember it, so she's just been flying around her whole life. Might put you to sleep again. So, honestly, that doesn't... Yeah. That's not offensive. And I don't think anyone who does ASMR would consider that offensive, because that's, like, kind of the goal. You relax. Go to sleep. You know, that kind of deal. Anything. Unwind. And here's the original cover for the Dark Souls, The Age of Fire. It's pretty cool. This boss I've seen before, I think. I don't know who in chat has played Dark Souls, but that boss looks familiar. So much glare. That comic. It's on the wall. We have it. I made sure I ordered like a couple extra copies. The interior art is so good. Okay, that's it for comic books. And, Darren, I already opened my packs on stream the other night, but if I wouldn't have, I would have loved to have done some ASMR reading of what Mach 6 does. But we did that last week. Okay, let's put the comic books away. 6 is broken. Let me reread it. So it goes 3. It's water. It has 4,000 HP or 4,000 attack. If you control 2 or more Category 6 forwards other than Mach 6, Mach 6 can't be chosen by your opponent's summons or abilities. Draw 1 card to tap it. Or tap it, draw 1 card. Yeah, there's a lot of Final Fantasy VI really good characters. So yeah, only about, I don't know, 20 comics, 25 comics this week. Not quite as big as last week's, but still a hefty amount. Saying that most people only get like 2 to 3 books a week, which is also another reason why I feel kind of obligated to do this. There's a lot of comic book reviewers out there, but a lot of them don't get very many books each week, or they read them, you know, online, which is okay. But there's certainly not many ASMR comic book people. And if there are comic book people doing stuff like this, than me, and you know, that's okay. There's a way to untap him twice a turn, which would let you draw 5 cards in a single turn. That's pretty good. Alright, so that's going to do it for the comic book portion of tonight. If you're watching on YouTube, hopefully you're asleep. The stream is going to continue in ASMR for a good 2 hours or so. So, thanks for watching. Okay, that's just where I'm going to cut off the fucking, the forking video. Let me write down the timestamp. Actually, the Target near Quakertown has one right now. As a sponsor of the stream, because I talk about Arizona tea all the time on stream. We don't need to worry about this one. We don't need to worry about that one. Arizona tea's where it's at. This mic is very tall. This mic stand, I should say. Alright, we're gonna change this. Okay, so. If all is correct, and you have headphones in, you should be able to hear me as I kinda move around the microphone. You can hear things back here. Over here, and over here, and back here. But that's not the point of today. The point of today is to play some Isaac. Okay, I gotta move some stuff around. was pretty great. I'll tell you what, the best thing to do with Arnie Palmer is to eat it. Eat it. Is to drink it with spaghetti. You have some of my famous pasta. My medium shells. And some mixed vegetables and some Arnie Palmer iced tea. Best drink ever. No lie. You've literally never had better. Okay, nature sounds. I was born the 1st of January, 1999. That's a lie. That's just the first date that showed up. Maybe I'll play this. Because I have Dark Souls 1 on the Xbox, but this is remastered. And I haven't beaten it. I don't know. Is this game relevant to you? Checkmark, similar to games you've played. Doki Doki Literature Club. What? I'm gonna put it on my wish list. And we'll eventually get to it. We have so many games to play. I just started State of Decay 2. And that game's fantastic. It's fantastic. Okay, we're gonna play The Bindings of Isaac. I apologize, this may be slightly too loud. Right away. As long as I can get through it quickly. Like, the beginning part is always a little louder than I'd like. Oops. Is this okay? Or is this too loud? What console do you play on? So, I mostly play on my PC, you know? Let's move it down to Isaac. Mostly I play on my PC, but I do own an Xbox One and a 360 and a new 3DS, but I plan on getting a Wii U. I got a Wii U for Breath of the Wild. I plan on getting a PS4 because Death Stranding and God of War and Horizon Zero Dawn look phenomenal, and I want them. Thank you. guys having a great and relaxing night. I know I am. I've never seen these enemies before. That's too loud or too quiet. It's pretty loud in my headphones, but I have a feeling it's not that loud. This fight takes forever when you have no damage. So this run, this daily run, has to go to Mom's heart. If it doesn't make it that far, well, I'm screwed. This is the seeded run that everyone on PC in the world today can do. So if you have Isaac on the PC, and you have Afterbirth Plus, the DLC, you can do this run alongside me. I'm so sorry. Just a person, thanks for the follow, man. I forgot that I switched scenes and didn't have it muted. Didn't have it muted for that scene. So sorry. So all of the runs are the same because you get ranked at the end on a global ranking via Steam based on how good you did points wise, how many points you got compared to everyone else in the world. channels. It helps to grow channels. It helps to help you find new channels. We're currently number 5th in Isaac. Number 5 in Isaac. If you click that link, it takes 2 seconds. I'm already back in the game. It takes 2 seconds. It votes for the channel. And in top streamers, you can search by a game. And it'll rank 1 through, you know, a million. A stream based on how many votes their community has given to them. And you can only vote once a day. And you vote by clicking on that link. It's completely free. You don't need an account. You just click the link. That's it. Shop. Oh, Fear Shot. Fear Shot makes enemies very unpredictable in terms of movement. See what you got, Satan. Guppy Scholar. I'll take a piece of Guppy. Guppy Scholar means that every time I die, there's a 50% chance that I just come back to life. That's pretty cool. Okay, I'm not gonna reroll this. I'm just gonna leave. Save my coins for next floor. Let's check in here. I'm gonna wait till I see what the item room is and see if it's worth going in there. It's really only worth going in there treasure map. VCR. Treasure map. Get the fully visible map. So it looks like the item room is down. The boss room is in a tiny room. Let's see what the boss is. Mega fatty in a small room. That's fair. See, I used the continuum tears to TNT him from the other side of the room. It's almost dead. Close. Another devil tail. It's Krampus. Charges you and uses his cross beam attack, guaranteed it's going to spin, so you know to move. And if he just does it naturally, he doesn't spin. There was no way previously to tell if that was gonna happen. Hey CBGX, thanks for the bits, man. Hey Little Horn. Praise be to Little Horn. Challenge room. Because I'm just going to lose my heart for the next floor. Kind of just want to see if this is a secret room. Probably wasn't going to be that one. It was most likely the one to the right near the shop. These have so much HP. stop spawning flies. If I actually hit my shots. Guess I was wrong about the location of the boss room. It's okay. Just don't hit the spikes. I had to use that there. I was in a very dangerous spot. Up to save my life. I just want a little bit of damage. Just a little. Let's go to the right. Let's see what's going on over here. To the shop. a steam sail. Running low on HP though. Probably should have used my grandpa's head. So how did you goof with leveling up? It's three. I killed two. Just want to spread some damage. It's hard to explain, but there are different skill trees, and you wanted to get a specific upgrade, but you need to upgrade anything in the magic skill set in order to unlock it. I thought it meant I have to upgrade that specific skill, even though I didn't care about that upgrade. Oh, I see. Yeah, games need to explain their leveling up systems. And not just over-explain everything else, and then under-explain the important shit. 10 bombs. These items have been terrible. Absolutely terrible. Charm. Never press the buttons. Don't do it. Also, don't fuck up your bombs. Let's go fight the boss. It's okay. Let's check this over here. All my hands. Can sometimes have cards or black hearts in them, so I'm gonna die. I knew as soon as I walked in that room I'd take at least one damage, and I couldn't use my Krampus head because I still need one more charge. So I have to plan it. So I already know this run's gonna suck. So my tears rotate around my body. This item sucks, by the way. If you didn't figure that out. Unless you have, like, insane amounts of tears. It's not good. You basically have to fire opposite of where you want it to go for it to be the most effective. It's so hard to hit things. Static to wherever you threw them. Dummy. Walked right into it. So well tonight. Just getting hit by all sorts of dumb shit. Do you ever do well? This is gonna suck. I'm already dying. I fucking hate the little planet so much. So the spacebar item I have places down a little turret that fires tears that are exactly the same as mine, no matter what kind of tears I have, like brimstone or bee tears or whatever. Satan, I do not want your pills. That will save me. Do I open that? Potentially get some flight? It's okay. Could have been way better. Could have had, you know, a key in it. Or two keys. Or flight. Or, I don't know. Anything else? So I can charge my tears now. And they're giant circles. These circles deal ticking damage. Anything in contact with the ring takes damage. So you can fire little ones. The little ones obviously have a smaller surface area. But they still deal damage along the circle. So if you touch an enemy with a smaller one, it deals a ton of damage because it, you know, it hits the enemy more times than if you hit it with a big one. Just does a little bit more overall damage. It's not Dark Rock. It's a really good improvement. So I'm going for Mega Satan. So if we 100% get a Devil Deal, I can't take it. wake up, boss. I don't want to waste my space bar in case we get Krampus. See, the little tears are doing tons more damage than the big tears because they're just hitting the boss so many more times. This is really good. Krampus, see? Shops or the shop or the library. So the shop is going to be as far away from the starting area as possible. So probably the room to the right of us over to is probably the shop. We'll check that out soon. was right. It was the same thing that was in the last one. Charge between the ghost baby and me, which doesn't really do much because we're so close together. Steam sale. Okay, so if we donate 10 coins to the donation machine, it'll up our chance to get a devil deal. Spacebar item's so good now. Pajamas. I feel cozy in my pajamas. Alright, that's mom's eye. Left hand. I'll pick it up, but I don't need it. That turns all chests to red chests, and I don't need red chests. Those are new, they're not enemies, but they're new objects. I guess they have a chance of not sucking you in, just like turning off. That's interesting. Absolutely. No machine. I do want this though. It's an XL. Curse of the blind. Don't touch that. It'll just hurt you. Backstabber, watch your back. So I should be able to find the secret room at least. Let's try here. It's 100% chance to get a double deal. I don't have red hearts to take red heart damage to decrease that chance. So I guess I'm just gonna have to deal with no Mega Satan. It's actually pretty difficult to get to Mega Satan. It's not guaranteed ever. Oops, I just used my card by accident. Use a little bit more damage. the shop. I'm kind of forced to just go fight mom. Trapped on one of these sides because the chest that spawned here was a mimic chest, the ones that poke out spikes and damage you. It's like a mod game, really. You can do that to me, force me to take damage. Chest was one of the spike mimic chests. One more. I don't know why I came in here for one more. Okay. Let's go back and fight mom. Then on to Isaac. Should be okay as long as we can get there. Don't touch the red poop, man. What's going on out there? What touched me? person has appeared in the basement. Buddy in a box has appeared in the basement. Achievement unlocked. Okay. Let's go fight Isaac. I'm not gonna do, hush. I've already done the unlock for hard mode hush on Eden. And if I haven't, I'm gonna punch myself. Because that would suck. The basement. This is actually the cathedral. What's up, American boy? I'm super quick too. No angel room. God, this sucks. This is my last chance to get Mega Satan's key. Alright, with a 62% chance to get it. Changes your character. That'd be cool, right? Just get different unlocks on different characters. Fuck you, Stain. So good. Jess. What the fuck? Just gotta focus so I don't die. GG. So, yeah, I only needed, Mega Satan. Out of this. ASMR human. But tomorrow we're going to be playing State of Decay 2. Friday is going to be Fallout 4. Saturday is Terraria. And then Tuesday is whatever. And then next Wednesday is more ASMR shit. Yeah. I want to do, I think next week, we're going to try the first half, like normal. It's going to be comic books, comic book related. The second half, I think we're just going to do regular ASMR. Like, we're just going to sit here, we're going to chat. Hopefully there's, a couple people so I can, talk about something. But we're going to do a lot of trigger sounds. Like, I'm going to unplug this. Not this. Okay. We're going to do, like, trigger sounds. Like,